What's going on, guys? It's Jambs here, and I'm coming back to you after about a month and a half of an absence, mainly due to the fact that I was on leave, and I've been dealing with kind of a little bit of a hectic schedule at the moment where I haven't had much free time to sit down, record a video, edit it out, and then post it up. So I know a few of you were asking me to make a video about Nuclear Field A School, so this is going to be exactly that. Now, I know some of you might have just signed a contract to be a nuke because either a recruiter threw a bunch of bonuses in your face, or because you actually are interested in joining the world's finest Navy and the best nuclear power program in the world. So, if you did that, good, congrats. And this is going to be a little video just kind of explaining what you're going to experience when you first get down here in South Carolina at the A School, and what you're going to experience kind of in boot camp when you're selecting your prospective rates. So when you go to the nuclear recruiters there at boot camp, you are going to pick your top two wish list rates from the three. There are the machinist mates, MMs, the electricians mates, the EMs, and the electronic technicians, ETs. That's what I am. So you kind of get the choice of which one of the three you want to be, but in reality, you don't really get a choice. They just kind of pick for you. But you get to put your opinion in, and, you know, opinions are like whatever, however the quote goes. So if you don't really have much information that you don't know what the three different rates are, MMs typically are the ones that work on valves and pumps within the power plants. EMs work on pretty much the power distribution without the power plant and wires and such. And then the electronic technicians are the ones that work on the actual instrumentation and control equipment within reactors. And all three rates have a very distinct responsibilities to actually maintaining and running the reactor itself. You learn a lot of that when you go to power school and prototype, especially prototype when you get hands-on experience. But for picking one of your three rates, whichever one you really have more of a background in or you're just more interested in, you can put on your wish list for. Might not necessarily get it, but it's good to try. So when you first arrive down here, you're gonna fly in. Some flights, you know, my flight didn't land here till 3 a.m. Some people got here at noon. Some people got here at like 4 p.m. There's all different times people arrive, but it's pretty much the same. You go through a little check-in process. You get a nice little in-doc badge, and you just kind of get your room assignment for that day. Typically, most flights come in on the weekend, and the weekends are nice because the weekends are yours. You really do whatever you want to do on the weekends that are within your within kind of your limitations and restrictions depending on your phase. So the phases start where phase one, you know, you're restricted to base Monday through Friday. You cannot leave. And then Friday afternoon after the workday to Sunday, you can leave base as long as you're in your NSUs or the Naval Service uniform. And that's the only way that you could leave. You cannot consume alcohol. You cannot stay off base overnight unless you route a special request chit. You cannot drive your own vehicle. However, this phase one only stays for about 2 to 3 weeks once you actually class up and go through life skills with your class. That's when you'll finally get phase two. But when you actually finally get phase two, you get to have a little bit more freedom. Alcohol is allowed to be consumed as long as you're above the age of 21. You're allowed to drive your own vehicle. You are allowed to leave base during the week in uniform, as well as during the weekends in civilian clothing. And you can wear civilian clothing on the weekends as well, like on base. So it's kind of more relaxed, but it's still strict with the week-long can leave base, but you have to always be in uniform. You can't wear civilian clothes during the week. And then when you finally hit phase three, that's when you get to wear civilian clothes during the week, during the weekends, all after the working day, of course. And you can leave base during the week, and you could also spend overnight off base on Fridays and Saturday nights. So it's kind of it's a much more openness, a lot more freedom when you're phase three, and it's a privilege. So you can lose it if you screw up along the way, but you know, just don't lose it. So when you finally class up from Indoc, you're going to meet your SLPO. Who's going to be in charge of your class while you go through A school, either MMA school, which is 3 months long, or ET or EMA school, which is 6 months long. And when you first class up, you're going to go through life skills, which is just a week long of presentations. After that, you'll finally get phase two, and then you'll finally just jump into your curriculum. When you initially start, you're going to start off with mathematics because everyone needs math. You know, you need to know math for pretty much every single subject you learn, every single thing that you incorporate. You need to use math one way or another. So you're going to start with math. MMs veer off with their own classes. They pretty much learn how to like operate certain tools, test equipment, system components. Learn about valves, learn about hammers, learn about pumps. You pretty much learn anything, like you're a mechanic, you know, so you're going to learn about how to fix them and how to operate them. The EMs and ETs actually have a kind of side-by-side A school up until their final class, both of which pretty much will go through learning about electricity, electronics. You learn about like logical systems, microprocessors, instrumentation and control equipment. You learn how to read schematics. You know, you learn there's a lot of this stuff that you get to actually learn and then apply with hands-on. Especially ETs, you get to troubleshoot on an actual circuit that's faulted. So that's, you know, pretty cool. The EMs will veer off of their own, learning about specific power distribution and specific electronic equipment. So it's, you know, each wire rate is important in themselves. I'm an ET, so I only learned what an EM learned. So when you're going through A school, you're going to be set assigned to a certain study hour program. Everybody starts off on 15 Tech Twos, which is you have to do 2 hours a day preceding an academic day, as well as a total of 15 hours during the week. So Monday through Thursday, you have to do 2 hours, as well as on that Sunday, and you have to have a total of 15 hours added up for that week. And that's, you just start on that after your first three exams, and then depending on what your GPA is, you get to change to either voluntary hours, so you put in whatever hours you think are necessary, 10 zeros, which is just 10 hours during the week, no daily requirement, 15 twos, 20 twos, 23s, 25 tac fours, and then the worst, which I haven't really heard anyone of, is 30 tac fives. I'm pretty sure you can only get those in power school and you have to have the CO's approval, but you know, so if you are struggling through the program, you will be put on worse hours, but it just kind of, it's more to better yourself and to put in those hours and use them responsibly to learn all the information that's present in front of you. And also during these hours, there's a lot of people that are there to help you. There's instructors that stay in the evening that if you ever are struggling on certain information or struggling on certain subjects, you get to go to them and pretty much just ask certain questions, run through problems, and they're really helpful. They know their stuff. They've been out to the fleet, and this is their short command. So they're here to pretty much help everyone that's going through school because we are going to be their reliefs one day. So they want us to know our shit, and you know, you're going to. So they're extremely helpful, and it's probably one of the best programs of after hours that I can really think of to go to. Now, you don't necessarily have to pass every single exam that is present in front of you. You can fail an exam. However, if you fail a subject, an entire subject, which takes the GPA from the exams that you have taken throughout that subject, and then it averages out, failure is below a 2.5 GPA. And if you are below that, then that will count as a subject failure. You can, at maximum, fail two subjects. Math is only a week and a half, 2 weeks long, so some people tend to actually fail that, and then they lose their safety net to where if they fail one more subject, they'll have to undergo a academic board, which is you going in front of instructors to pretty much, they'll ask you different questions, different information that you should know, and you have to present it in front of them on the board. I know a few people have gone to them and they've passed, so just don't fail. Try your hardest to actually get through. I know a lot of people who have struggled through A school, but they still made it out, thankfully, and they made it out strong and knowing their stuff. Some people just aren't good at taking exams. That's why they have this academic board, to allow people to verbally express the answers instead of having to write them down on paper. At the end of all of A school, you're going to take a comprehensive exam, which is going to be your final, so to speak, which is just going to be everything that you learned throughout A school on one exam. So they say it's like the, you know, it's the god of the tests for A school, because you can pass through A school perfectly fine with like a 3-4 GPA, you're an honor student or whatever, and then you could fail comp and still be able to fail out of the program. So it's, for myself, I've had a good experience through A school. I've been able to keep 10 zeros through A school, keeping a decent GPA. One of my closest shipmates did not have a good experience through A school, failed a few tests, went through with like a lower GPA, was worried about failing comp, and actually ended up failing comp. But when you fail comp, you either take an academic board or you just retake it 2 weeks later. So he chose the option to retake it 2 weeks later, and 2 weeks later he passed with flying colors and he was good to go. So failing isn't the end of something. It's pretty much, it's more or less the start of a rebirth, really. So just because you fail something doesn't mean that you have to quit right then and there. You can easily come back and just join up with the same exact people you were just with. Then after all of that, you get to join T-Track, which is, for some people, 2 straight months. Other people will join later, so it'll be like a month and a half, 1 month, waiting for your power school class up. And during this time, you will just be standing watches on base in the school center, standing duties. You run on different hours program, 12 on, 12 off, 12 on, 24 off, 24 on, 24 off, 24 on, 48 off. During that 48 off, you don't actually get 48 hours straight off. You have like a work day on those 2 days until 1600, but after that, the day is yours, so it's not that bad. This whole transition track is pretty much just to be able to use everyone that is waiting to class up for power school to just fulfill the duties. So that's pretty much all I got for you guys for this video. I have a link in the description with all of the sources that I pulled information from, just to kind of, if you guys want to read up on it more and get more kind of in-depth information that can be, you know, read about instead of just watching a video. So if you guys liked this, please let me know, and let me know if there's anything else that you would like me to upload or talk about, because I know this was a video that was made mainly because you guys said, hey, we want to know, you know, about A school. So all right, here you go. So yeah, just let me know what you guys think. And I think I'll do like an interview with some of the people that I know that have struggled through A school, so you can get their opinions on it. And yeah, so this is Jambs, and I'm out. Peace.